Welcome to the online training for the Wisconsin Bumble Bee Brigade, a statewide citizen-based monitoring project. This training is divided into multiple parts, all of which are available through this YouTube playlist. This video provides an introduction to Bumble Bee Biology. Wisconsin has 400 to 500 species of native bees. Of those, most, about 85%, are solitary. That means they do not live communally in colonies. The rest are social or semi-social, meaning they live together in colonies. This includes our 20 species of native bumblebees. We also have one species of non-native social bee in Wisconsin. That's the European honeybee. Honeybees are not native to the US. They are an agricultural species classified as livestock by the state. As stated, bumblebees are social. They live together in colonies with a queen, workers, which are also female, and males. They have annual colonies, meaning they last for only 1 year. Bumblebees are found in many habitats, usually where a continuous supply of pollen and nectar, which is what they eat, is available throughout the growing season. You can find them in meadows, prairies, savannas, agricultural landscapes, gardens, wetlands, and parks and urban habitats. They are most diverse in temperate and montane areas as opposed to warmer climates. In Wisconsin, bumblebees are active starting in early to mid-April through October, with some variation between species. They are very hairy and don't do well in extreme heat, so on hot days they are mostly active early and late in the day. Bumblebees feed on nectar and pollen. They are unique in that they perform buzz pollination on flowers. This means they vibrate their flight muscles while on or in a flower, and the vibrations release pollen. In most of our species of bumblebees, females have a specialized structure called a corbicula on the hind legs. It is a wide, smooth surface surrounded by long hairs. When the bees collect pollen from a flower, it settles into the hair on their bodies, and they groom themselves and push the pollen onto their corbicula. In this photo, the bee is carrying a large amount of orange pollen on her corbicula. As mentioned, bumblebee colonies are annual, with only the newly produced queens, called gynes, surviving over the winter to create new colonies. In the spring, the queens emerge from underground hibernation and begin searching for a nest site, as you see at the top of the diagram. Nest sites are usually underground, for instance, an abandoned rodent burrow, but some species prefer to nest above ground. The queen feeds on nectar, and once she has selected a nest site, she collects pollen in order to feed her future colony. Once she has stored enough food, she lays eggs, which develop into the colony's first worker bees. Workers are always female. Once the first brood of daughters has emerged, as seen at the bottom of the diagram, they begin to forage for the colony, and the queen devotes herself to egg laying. Successful colonies grow over the course of the summer, with more and more workers being produced. In late summer or early fall, the colony begins producing males and new queens, called gynes. Worker bees and old queens die, and the new queens and males leave the colony to mate. Once a queen has mated, she stores the sperm and hibernates. The males die, and the new queens emerge in the spring, and the cycle repeats itself. Again, bumblebee nests are social colonies founded by a single queen. As covered in the previous slide, they last only a single season. Nests can have 100 to 400 workers, or perhaps even more. Nests are often found in abandoned rodent burrows, under logs, or in tufts of grass. Sometimes bumblebees even nest in artificial structures like a birdhouse or a crevice in a wall. Very little is known about where bumblebee queens overwinter. It is believed they burrow a few inches underground beneath the leaf layer, which eventually gets covered with snow. Overwintering bumblebees are seldom found. This photo shows a rare exception. A university employee taking soil cores for an unrelated project pulled up an overwintering rusty patch queen, to his great surprise. Cuckoo bumblebees have a different life history strategy than what we have discussed so far. They are nest parasites, meaning that they invade the nests of bumblebees of other species and lay their eggs in them. The eggs are then reared by the worker bees from that nest. Because their young are cared for and raised by other species, cuckoo bumblebees do not have to collect and carry pollen back to a nest. So, they do not have a corbicula on the hind leg. This is a good way to tell them apart from other bumblebees. In Wisconsin, we have 5 species of cuckoo bumblebees, but only 3 of them have been found recently in the state. It is possible the other 2 cuckoo species are no longer found in Wisconsin, but you never know. Perhaps a Bumblebee Brigade volunteer will make an exciting discovery while monitoring. Because cuckoo bumblebees are nest parasites, occasionally some people view them in a negative light. But we are equally concerned with monitoring and protecting all our native bumblebees, including cuckoos. A healthy host population can withstand and support the presence of cuckoos in the area. This concludes the training video on bumblebee biology. If you are new to the project, please be sure to watch all the training videos.